lucky to grow up in a small town, places like this close by, you know. Always got to travel, and I had parents that encouraged us to get out of the house. Not like today, sitting in front of a screen and everything's make-believe, you know. We lived real lives, went out and did real things. Spent a lot of times outdoors. I love the outdoors. Spending times in the woods with my buddies, and a lot of times by myself too. Used to take my acoustic guitar and just head down there, and that's where I wrote my first song, actually. And the time will come when all will go away. And when the time comes, I wanna know I live my way. Thinking back on things they had to say, I remember I was told to walk my own road, walk my own road.
1964, when I was 11 years old and the Beatles landed at Kennedy Airport in New York and later played on the Ed Sullivan Show, I saw them and knew what I wanted to do. I wanted to play guitar, and I wanted to be in a band, and I wanted to be on a stage and do it for the rest of my life, playing guitar for a living. I wanted to be a Beatle. After the Beatles broke up, I was kind of lost for a while, but we weren't at a loss for talent that came along. I was also into Johnny Winter, Cream with Eric Clapton, later Led Zeppelin with Jimmy Page, and of course Jimi Hendrix. I was into Jeff Beck. Guitar players like Santana, anybody that played a guitar. B.B. King was an early influence of mine, but the main ones, especially just as the Beatles were breaking up and during high school and after high school, were Johnny Winter and Eric Clapton and Jimmy Page, really. Those were the guys. Shibuya was actually the first place I lived away from home. I moved away from my house into the Shibuya, and while I was living there, got to see and hear some of the greatest bands in the world, and actually got to meet a lot of them too. It was quite educational and quite an entertainment thing, and it was great to be there and see the bands come in right from the beginning, watch them set up their gear and do the sound checks, and then watch the show and get to meet them afterwards if possible. It was just what an education. When I was first approached to join Avalanche, I wasn't in a very good place mentally. I didn't really want to go with another band. I had just gotten out of another band and been on the road for a while, so I really wanted to get some rest. And I was really reluctant to join the band, but when I found out who was going to be in the band and later went up and heard the direction that they were going to go in musically, I had no choice, really. I needed to do it. For me, that was one of the best decisions I ever made. Got me into a class band, a band that did all original music that I had a hand in writing, which is what I always wanted. Playing with Avalanche on the stages that we played for, the audiences that we played for, was a real step up from any of the other bands I had been in. They were the largest audiences I had ever played for, and it was night after night after night. All the audiences were almost sell out or sell out, and it was a totally different thing to be able to go on and play one good long set of all original material and have it go over the way it went over with those audiences. I believe music is the great communicator, and for me, my guitar speaks better for me than my words do. I can say more in a musical phrase sometimes than I can get across with my words.
Can't take the clouds from across the sun. I can't make this world be a free one.
Can't believe I remembered that. I think it is the music. It's that vision that, you know, that you want to keep going. You just want to keep playing. It doesn't matter. The money never mattered. So What do you play for? You play for music. You play for that next discovery, that next song. It just never feels finished.